Hey guys, this is Commander of PBR 140, so I'm doing another narrated battle here, so let's get started. I lead off with Ambipom and Absol, and I lead off with Solrock and something else, a Clefable. And they switch out their Solrock to bring in their own Umbreon, which is quite cool. So I go for the fake out with Ambipom, because that's just one of Ambipom's main moves. And does a fair amount of damage, you know, because I've got life orb and all that, so it's going to be pretty decent. So I go for a sword stance with Absol, because I want to get good attacking power, because it's just what Absol does. And Clefable goes for a video mash, but that won't do much damage, because Clefable doesn't really have the best offensive stat. So, yeah, unless it's using Facade or a Toxic Orb or something like that. So, Clefable goes for a follow me, which is, well, to be honest, isn't really that bad, because I actually went for the taunt Grampy Palm, because I don't know why, I just thought it might try soft boiled or something, I don't know, I thought it might do something other than attack, but I also went for the superpower, but that was meant for Clefable anyway, and I get a critical hit, which is obviously going to, oh, knock him down to his sash actually, I find that quite rare actually, but yeah. Turns out the Clefable was holding a focus sash, and Umbreon goes for a yawn, which is kind of annoying, because, you know, it's going to send me to sleep at the end of the next turn. So, I'll go for a Sucker Punch with Absol just to get rid of that Clefable, because it's just being a bit of a blasted nuisance. So the Clefable goes down, which is good news for me. And, right. And, I go for a double hit with Ambipom. And, I believe it does a fair amount of damage. You know, it does pretty good, actually. You know, one more will finish the Umbreon off. Yeah, and obviously I'm going to take Life Orb Recoil, and the Umbreon goes for a payback on Absol for some reason. I don't know why they would go for Absol for some reason. You know, got no idea. I guess they was expecting me to go for a superpower, and just thought they choose a random move. But anyway, so they bring back in their Solrock, and I go for a little double hit to get rid of that Umbreon, so that's good for me. So, bye-bye Umbreon. So, the Umbreon goes back in its Pokeball. I'm actually going to narrate quite a lot of battles, because, you know, a lot of people have been asking me to narrate, so I'm going to start narrating more often, you know. I mean, I think of the last batch I had, I think I narrated, like, I think it was 8, or maybe more. But anyway, they go for a Rock Slide, and, unfortunately, get a critical hit on Ambipom. It would have been so much better if that critical hit happened on Absol. You know, but unfortunately, I lose both of my guys. But, you know, they both did a pretty good job. So, you know, it's cool. So, I'll bring in my next Pokemon, which is Pikachu and Driftblim. Because, you know, it has to be Driftblim because of the title. And they also bring in their Jirachi. And I bring in Driftblim. And Driftblim actually did unbelievably well in this battle. You wouldn't believe. There was this one part that, actually, I won't spoil it, you'll see it soon. So, yeah, Jirachi goes for a charge beam on Driftblim, which isn't going to do that much, but it is going to give them a special attack boost. Yeah, well, 70% chance of that happening. And it's a thing, or does Serene Grace boost the chance? I don't actually know, does Serene Grace boost the chance of charge beam's effect? I don't know, actually, I don't know. So, I get up a Calm Mind to Driftblim, and then I get up a substitute with good old Pikachu. And, Jirachi goes for a Draco Meteor. And, Driftblim actually survives it. And it's like, wow, I'm surprised he actually took it, you know. But that's not the best part. You'll see the next one, Laughter. So, he goes for a Zen Headbutt, which is actually good, because if he you know. Because if he'd gone for Driftblim, he most likely would have been knocked out. So I go for a Shadow Ball, and surprisingly, I actually knock out the Solrock. I did not expect to knock the Solrock out. Solrock can be a bit bulky, but honestly, I really thought he'd survive that for some reason. So I get up another substitute with Pikachu. Now, here's the part of the battle that I really liked. Watch this. Look at that. He just barely took that hit. It's like, wow, I can't believe it. He actually took that hit, no problem. And I get up a rare, so I get all that back. It's like, wow, I can't believe it. You know, it's just fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. You know, I'll tell you, I never knew Driftblim could be that good. You know. So I go for a Shadow Ball, which does a good amount of damage, and then I'm just going to, and then get a special defense drop, but that doesn't really matter. So I'm just going to go for a Vault Tackle with Pikachu and finish that Jirachi off. So that's the end of the battle. So I shall see you all in the next battle. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all later.